Okay, so in this video we will be discussing about the calculator, which is much useful in the exam, especially in the RME exam. So we'll be talking about today the Casio FX570ES calculator. So there is a higher model in this calculator, the 991ES, but as of I believe that was year 2018, the use of that calculator in taking the board exam is prohibited because in the reason that the TRC believes that model of exam can be programmed, or it is that calcule is a programmable one. So that's why the use of that calcule was banned during the exam. So the highest model of Casio calculator that is allowed in the exam as of now is the 570ES. Okay, so that there are also some gossips or some information, but it is not yet it is not yet verified, or the PRC does not have or does not release any official statement or any official order or memorandum that this model is also banned. So I believe that was last year's civil engineering exam that the PRC released a certain order banning this type of calculator, but later on they withdrew the ban. So during the conduct of the exam, still this model of calculator is used by the examinees, na? Okay, so this calculator compared to the 991ES, as of course that is a higher model, so it has a more functions, so it has more function compared to this one. But in this video or in the succeeding videos, because I believe it will be a 3-part video or 4-part video, we will be focusing only on the functions that is useful, especially in taking the RME exam. Okay, so first we must familiarize ourselves with the calculator itself. Okay, so maybe some of you have been using this calculator, so maybe this will just be a breeze for you. But for those who have not yet used the calculator or not even buy this calculator, so it is a good time for you to buy this one. And we just hope that during the exam, maybe next year, due to the pandemic, the exam has been canceled. But we just hope that maybe next year, this model of calculator will still be allowed to be used during the examination. Okay, so basically this is the appearance of the calculator. Okay, so the actual appearance of the calculator, it has its own cover. So because I'm only using the software, the emulated software of the FX570ES calculator. So but the actual appearance of this one, still we have the front. This is the front view of the calculator. Then we have also the cover. So if you buy the calculator, it has its own cover, and on that cover you have the list of the constants and the unit conversion, of which I will be also discussing later on this video. Okay, now let's first focus on the front view of the calculator, in which the magic or the action happens. Okay, so we have here the screen. This one is the screen. So the screen is a natural display. What do you mean by natural display? Meaning you can write exactly what is written, especially in the if you are going to write a mathematical expression, For example, if I want to have a mathematical expression of x squared, that's the wrong color of pen. Okay. For example, you have to use x squared over 2x. Okay. So if you want to write that one in a calculator on the older model of a calculator, you cannot write this one exactly. So you will be writing someone like this. So I will just have the mode, the setup of this one in the older display. So you will be writing that one like this one. So you have x, then okay, then that will be fraction, so over 2 alpha x. So it is not the same with this one. So the display of your calculator is not the same of what is actually written on the mathematical statement or in this part. So what will you do is to for this part, you will be this is not the natural display. So but the Casio 570 ES calculator, it has a setup in which you can have the natural display. So for example, we will have the natural display of this one. We could write that exactly how we want it to be written. So that is the natural display of a 570 ES calculator. So it is much better, it is for this natural display, because we could especially in checking the inputs of our calculator, we could easily check the inputs of our calculator. Okay, now we will go to the buttons, to the functions. Okay, so first we have this button, of course, on. So if your calculator is in the off state, so if you will be pressing that button, it will be on. Then we have also the off, but the off is a second function, so you will have shift off. And because this is a software, so it cannot be off, just off this one by clicking the close button. But in the actuality, if you are trying to off your calculator, you just press shift and off. And the calculator also has its auto off function. I believe that is 3 to 5 minutes idle. So if you are not using your calculator for 3 to 5 minutes, the calculator will automatically turn off by itself. Now, let's have the setup of the calculator. So the setup. So first, in order to access the setup menu, so you just click shift. So this one, shift. Then this one, this button. So that is setup. So if you are clicking the shift button, this one, I believe that is brown, so brown in color. So if you are pressing the shift button, the S will appear in this part of the screen. So meaning you are now trying to access the second function of your button. So what is the second function? So the second function are those written above the button, or this button, or any other button below, which has the same color as your shift button here. So for example, if you are pressing shift, then you press this button, so you will enter the setup menu. Okay, now we have the setup menu here. Okay, so the setup menu has 8 options. So first we have the math IO, or I believe some of that will call MAT 10 or MTH 10, but for me that is MAT IO. The IO means input output. So if you select this one, so how to select this one? This is number 1. So you just press 1. So then you will be prompted with a question. So result format, so it is MAT 0, so meaning the output must be in mathematics. For example, the exact output would be in this one, like this one, fraction. Then line 0, so meaning the line 0 line output, meaning your output will be in the old version of the calculator. So let's first try to have the MAT output. Okay, so we select 1. So for example, if I will be calculating, for example, 8. So let's have here a fraction 8. So this is the natural display. So this is the MAT IO. 8 divided by 6. So if I will be pressing the equal sign, so you will have 4/3. So exactly like a fraction. Because if you are going to answer this one by hand, so our answer will be like this one, 4/3. So just divide both sides, divide the numerator and denominator by 2, so we have 4/3. So that is what you mean by MAT output. Now if we have the line output, so we'll just have this one, 2. Okay, so that is 8 divide 6. Then you will have the decimal 1.333. The answer will be automatic in decimal. But compared to the MAT 0, so we just go back to the MAT 0. Okay, so MAT output. So we have 8 divide 6. So your output will be in fraction. Okay, then we will go to another setup. So we have the line IO. So that is the older version of the display. So line IO. So for those of you who are much familiar with this mode or setup, or have been using the older model of calculator, so you could set your 570ES to this mode so that you will not be confused with the display. Okay, so for example, if you are going to input a fraction, so 8/9, so that will be the older display using your old calculator, the MS model. So the 570 MS, the 350 MS, so that is the older model of the Casio calculator. Okay, we go now to another option on the setup. We have the degree. So when you say degree, so all your angles will be in the unit of degrees. Okay, degrees. So for example, if you are going to input 30 degrees, cosine of 30 degrees, so the calculator will interpret the angle, the 30, as a degree. Then the radians, so the radians, so your calculator will interpret the angle, for example, cosine 30, so the calculator will interpret the 30 as a radian. Then the gradient, still a unit of angle, so your calculator will interpret your input angle as a gradient. Okay, then we have the fixed function, in which if you are going to round up or round down your answer, so you could assign a fixed value. So fixed value, so fixed number of digits. For example, if you want only to have an answer of 3 digits, so 3 significant digits, so you could input 3. So you will have 3 decimal point. So let's go back with the 8 divided by 6. Okay, so it is equal to 1.33. Well, in fact, this answer is equal to 1.3333. This is a non-terminating decimal. Non-terminating repeating decimal. But because you have set up your calculator fixed digit, then the number of digit is 3, so you have 3 decimal places. Okay, going back again, you have the SI, scientific notation, in which all of your answer will be expressed in a scientific notation. Okay, so you will be also prompted with the option, how many significant digits do you want? For example, we will have 2. Okay, so if we are going to have our answer, for example, 8 divide 6. So you have 1.3 times 10 to the power of 0. So your answer is now rounded to its nearest decimal place, having 2 significant digits in which it is raised by 0. So for example, if we have 1,000, so this is much cooler, 1,000. So 1,000, if you are going to convert that one into scientific notation, you just press equals, and you have this one, 1 times 10 to the power of 3. So that is the psi option, the scientific notation option. Next, we have the norm. Okay, the norm. Okay. So the norm function, so will be prompted by 1 or 2. So if you are going to press 1, so it is the normal number of digits. So for example, 9.36 divide 2, so you will have 4.68. For example, we're going to press 1.333333 decimal place, you will have the same one. So it is normal, no rounding up, no conversion to scientific notation. Okay, so we have also the second option, 2, so still the same. Okay, then we have still another options, so few options. So this will be the how you will input the fraction. So the first one is it in the a mixed number, then the second one in proper or proper fraction, then we have the complex, the setup of the complex, the stat, the table, this is the RDEC. So it is the same with your with respect to the stat. So I believe this is not very useful in RME exam. We have the display, then the continuation. So that is the whole functions or the whole setup options of the setup. Okay, so in using this calculator, especially the RME exam, so you just need to remember this, I believe this 1, 2, 3. So maybe if you have a conversion for angles, so this will be radians to degrees or to radians, so maybe 1 up to 5, then always set your calculator to norm, unless if you are going, if the question require your answer to be in scientific notation. But there is a shortcut for that, or there is a function of that in this calculator, in which you will not need to set the whole program of the calculator to have an output of a scientific notation. Okay, so that will be all for the setup of the calculator. So we will be talking about the mode in the next video.